Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Syncfusion Blazor Chips component. In general, you can use the Chips component to display a block of text information and perform small actions. In this video, I am going to show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor Chips component to a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019. You will see some of its built-in features, such as adding and customizing styles and icons, and setting different chip types. I will also explain how to bind events to the chips component. To explore the other features available in the component, refer to the website link in the above YouTube card. First, I will start with the Blazor application creation process. For this, I need to make sure the .NET Core SDK's latest version is installed in my machine. I should also have Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 or 2022 installed to create a Blazor application. For this tutorial, I am going to create a new Blazor app. So, I open Visual Studio 2019 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor WebAssembly app and click Next. Then, I name my project Blazor Chip Sample and click the Next button. After that, click the Create button with the default target framework to complete the project creation. The project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly apps and how to add Syncfusion components to one, you can click the video link shown in the above YouTube card. Now, let's add the Blazor chip component. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Buttons NuGet package in my application. Open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I search for the Syncfusion Blazor Buttons in the Browse tab and install it in my project. Once the installation is complete, I navigate to the Imports Razor file and add the Syncfusion Blazor Buttons namespace. Now, I can start using the Blazor chip component in any of the components available in the Pages folder. Next, I open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. I register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the method @SyncfusionBlazor within this main method and register a valid license key in my application. So, let me register the trial license key by using the method registerLicense. I then need to define the CSS for the Blazor chip. I navigate to the index.html file under the www root folder to reference the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Now, the configuration is done. So, let me add the Blazor chip component. I open the index Razor page, remove the default code, and include the tag SFChip. Then, I need to define the chip items tag, which is of type array and can accept n number of chip item definitions inside it. I want to add 4 item, so I define 4 chip item tag inside the Blazor chip code. For these chip items, I will set appropriate display text. Now, I am going to run this example. See the output page now for chips rendered with appropriate text. By default, the chip selection type will be single. If I want to select multiple chips at a time, then I will set the selection type to multiple. When we look at the chips component now, I can select multiple chips from this set of chips. Next, I will show you how to add images to the chips component using two properties, leading icon URL and leading icon CSS. I am going to set an image for this chip using the leading icon URL property by defining the property and setting the source path to it. You can see that the chips component displays with the image. Now, I will show you how to apply built-in predefined styles. The available predefined chip styles are primary, success, informative, warning, and danger. From these chip styles, I am going to create a primary button. So, within this Blazor chip code, I define a property CSS class and assign the predefined class ePrimary to it. Looking at the output page now, the chip component is displayed with the primary chip style. Next, I plan to add avatar content to the component. So, I define the property leading text within this chip item tag and set the appropriate value to it. Looking at the output page now, the chip's component renders with avatar content. Next, I am going to apply a border with a transparent background. I change the CSS class value to the predefined class eOutline. See in the output page now, the chip's component renders with a transparent background, and the border is applied here. Next, I will show you how to make a chip an action chip using an event. First, I need to define chip events inside the Blazor chip's code. Then, I will add an onClick event with the appropriate event handler. I want to display content while clicking the chip, so let me define the variable chipText of type string. Now, I define the event handler displayChipText, which receives an argument of type chipEventArgs. Next, within this displayChipText method, I will set the chipText value as sentaText and call the method stateHasChanged to notify the chip's component that its state has changed and it should be re-rendered. Along with this, I will add a division element here with the value chipText to show the content after clicking the chip. Also, I have defined few CSS style within this style section. And now, you can see in the output page, when I click this chip, the defined content is shown. If I would like to add a delete icon in all the items, then I simply need to set the enable delete property to true within the Blazor chip's code. Look at the output page now, and the delete option is enabled for all the chips, and while clicking the delete icon, the chip is deleted. Also, you can add and customize the trailing icon of chip using the property trailing icon CSS. In this video, we have seen how to create a Blazor project using Visual Studio 2019 and add a Syncfusion Blazor Chips component to a WebAssembly app. We have seen how to add images, icons, avatar content, and events to the component. Also, we have seen how to customize chips using predefined styles. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.